Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Biru Soleha Raufi. I'm a 5th semester student of English Department in University of Muhammadiyah Professor Dr. Hamka. In this video, I'm going to present about the nature of questionnaire for data collecting method and the characteristic of questionnaire. And the purpose of this video is to fulfill or to complete the assignment of the quantitative subject. So without any further ado, let's jump to the presentation.
Okay, now let's start the presentation. The title is The Nature of Questionnaire for Data Collecting Method and the Characteristic of Questionnaire. The paper title is Exchanging Social Support in Online Teacher Groups, Relation to Teacher Self-Efficacy. So what is questionnaire? A questionnaire is a research instrument that consists of a set of questions or other types of prompts that aims to collect information from a respondent. There are two main types of questionnaire. The first is descriptive questionnaire, and the second is analytical questionnaire. And there is three types or three ways to collect data by questionnaire. The first is online, the second is face-to-face, and the third is by phone. In the questionnaire administration, it is divided into two types. The first is self-administered. The self-administered means when we are collecting data by ourselves by send the question directly to the respondent by using the internet, email, or online questionnaire. And the second type is interview type situation. In this type, we usually, or the researcher usually use two-way, such as telephone interview and face-to-face interview, depending on the situation. Next is type of questionnaire items or the characteristic of questionnaire. The first is open-ended questions, and the second is closed questions. Let's jump to the first. It is open-ended question. According to Bailey, 1994, open-ended questions are useful if the possible answers are unknown or the questionnaire is exploratory. The second point of the characteristic is open-ended questions are useful if there are so many possible categories of response. Next is open-ended questions leaves a space or draw lines for a free response. The next, open-ended questions fetch the authenticity, richness, depth of response, honesty, and candor. And the other point of open-ended question is it is carries problems of the data handling. What does it mean? It means that when the researcher collecting the data without any measures, the data collecting will be overloaded. The next is open-ended questions can lead to irrelevant and redundant information since it is there are so many possible categories of response. And next is it may take the questionnaire a bit long and discouraging. Next is open-ended questions make it difficult for the researcher to make comparisons since there are a lot of categories of responses. Now let's jump to the closed question. Closed questions highly structured, and according to Ohm 1992, closed questions enable comparisons to be made across groups in the sample. Again, according to the Bailey 1994, closed questions quicker to code and analyze than work-based data. The The next point is, it's helping the respondent to answer easily. And close questions, usually presented as dichotomous, multiple choice, constant sum, and rating scales. The next is, as Billy said, that it is quick to complete and straightforward to code. And according to Oppenheim again, close questions do not enable respondents to add any remarks, qualifications, and explanation to the categories. And the last point, according to Krasnick and Presser, 2010, close questions encourage mindless or less two-stroke responses. Now, let's see the instrument of the journal or the paper that I mentioned before. This is the instrument of the journal. Here we are going to find out what kind of type or what kind of the question type that the researcher use. Let's see to the first indicators, personal background and Facebook use. Here it said the questions is including about gender, highest level of education, years of teaching experience, and years of group membership. And here are some questions about Facebook use, such as times of login per day, cost of staying online per day, and type of online activities. From here, we can conclude that the question here are not using the, it is open-ended question, because it have a lot of various or a lot of possibilities to answer. So it is open-ended questions. And the second indicators of efficacy, we can see here. Yep, it said participants rated each item on a Likert type scale from 1 as totally disagree to 5 as totally agree. Same as the second indicator, the third indicator, providing and receiving online social support, is have this statement. Participants rated each item on a 5-point Likert type scale with 1 as not true all the time and 5 as true all the time. So as I highlighted here, this is the reason why the first indicator is using open-ended response, and the second and third indicators use the closed response. So this is the sources.
I think that's all from me, and I'm sure this video is going to help you one day. And also, don't forget to wash your hand every time you have to change, and don't forget to bring the hand sanitizer anywhere and anytime you go, and don't forget to drink a lot of mineral water because coronavirus is still here. So keep healthy, keep safe, and thank you so much for watching this video. Thanks for your time. Thanks for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye bye.